Oh man, if only there was a way I could make it so I was able to play Streets of Rage 3, even though I'm in B on the Mega Drive alphabet. Oh wait, there's a way. Bare Knuckle 3 for the Sega Mega Drive, the Japanese version of Streets of Rage 3. Now, this has a few minor differences, I'm told, from Streets of Rage 3, so it really justifies a go, which is what I'm gonna do. Nice. Let's have a good play of Bare Knuckle 3. Sega Mega Drive, here we go. It is literally just any excuse to play it, I'm afraid. But the fact that there is a B version in the alphabet is excuse enough for me. Now, we went Skate last time, who's Adam's brother, and he's pretty cool and pretty fast. You can see the sprites being improved slightly for Bare Knuckle 3. Blaze and Axel are my usual character choice, although in this one, Axel's a little hunched over, but his animations are nice, and his walk's good. Those big, massive Marty McFly trainers are kind of cool too. Work rather well. The character that no one really likes is Zan, who I'm going to pick today. I think maybe part of it is because his speed and jump are rubbish, but his reach is good. He's, yeah, I don't know. On balance, he's not as good as, oh, as Axel and Blaze. Now, you might remember in the last one video, I mean by one, I mentioned that the music in this is not particularly good. If I remember right in the story, this is all about bombs and stuff, but we'll find out when we get to Streets of Rage 3 and see it in English, because I can then understand it. actually, this bit of music is quite good. This is one of the few occasions where it is. Now, Streets of Rage 2 had this, and I never really mentioned it, but A button moves. That's an A button move right there. That's one as well. We can see it takes your energy off, you have to use them. Look at the energy already. So let's not use them. Now, Zan's kind of cool. He's a big cyborg dude. I think he's got basically a human head, and the rest of them is big blue robot in trousers. Actually, this is really nice to play. He's very powerful, but he's a bit slow. Again, graphically improved from the prequel, but no, the music is not as good. It started well. Have that. That's what that move's for. It started well, but I don't know. Just there's something missing from it. It's a bit of a drag music. It's a bit of a dirge. Haha, I didn't even notice that box there. I need that apple though, I can tell you that much. Good old fruit. Good old unpredictable fruit. If you've seen my previous videos of about 3 or 4 videos ago, you'll know what I'm on about there. What have I just picked up? That's right. Zan seems to convert weapons to pure energy. Which is a kind of a cool trait. I wonder if it's just because they couldn't be bothered to fit animations with a weapon in his hand. Still, I'm not complaining, it works for me. Oh, I hate them. Little dudes with knives who come charging at you. Let's confiscate that knife. Ah, in this one, unlike Streets of Rage 2, you can't pick up a weapon if you've already got a weapon. No, I prefer those moves where you throw, as I've said. Axel and Blaze, jumping over their heads and throwing them. That's the future. Throwing's good, yeah, it's a normal throw. Oh, no you don't. That is not how you throw. I'll show you how you throw. No, that is not how you throw. Oh, he's having a go though, isn't he? That's how you throw. That's not a throw. That's a throw. Right. Now, I think this is where one of the major changes was. Guy in boat, in a minute, bringing baddies on, I think is a big camp dude in this version, and in the slightly more prudish US UK versions, I think he was found to be a bit offensive. I'm not sure he is offensive, but I wouldn't know. And yeah, he was changed for someone else. I can't remember who he was changed for. Someone a bit nondescript, I think, which is a bit of a shame. Oh no, it was Thingy, wasn't he? He was changed for. Oh, what's the guy at Super Rage 2 called? oh, I can't remember his name, a recurring character for Streets of Rage 2, I think it was. Might be wrong about that. Answers on a postcard and all that. Oops, I tried to throw a fat guy. Never try and throw a fat guy. That's what happens when you try and throw a fat guy. What's his name? You know, the guy who, if you use the cheat, you can control. What's his name? I've forgotten his name. Well, yeah, it's him. And in this, here we go, this is it. In this version, the boat is driven by a big camp sailor. And it's the big camp sailor that was taken out. There he is. Big camp sailor in purple. He was taken out of the European version. And I think the American version. I suppose you'll kind of see why in a minute. But again, as I say, I don't think he's particularly offensive. I think he's just a character. He's just a colourful character like all these are. I mean, the motorbike dudes in shoulder pads could be considered offensive. As offensive as a big camp sailor. But yeah, you'll jump out in a minute and give me what for. A right good kicking, I mean. Actually, I don't know. Zan's doing alright here. I think he might be able to hold his own. Did I lose a life before? See, that's a bit of a weird move. I think it dehumanises him a bit, stuff like that. Which makes him less likable. But hey, he made a choice, they went with it. I think it made Streets of Rage 3 slightly more rubbish than Streets of Rage 2. But have you noticed the way the music's just kind of a single chord dirge? It's quite cool, it sounds good, it's that dynamic. The way the music, you know, the sounds within the music are dynamic, but the melodies aren't there. It's just dirgy. I'm hoping that will lock me onto that screen. Yeah, boss fight in a minute. And I never liked it. The music's like this throughout the game, as far as I remember. It's got this kind of techno dirge to it. Here we go. Yeah, they didn't like him. He's a little bit. No, he's a character, isn't he? Ash, that's his name. He's a character. He's a flippin' hard character as well. But listen to the music. It's like, it's kind of cool in its way, but I don't know, it's just lost all sense of melody, hasn't it? That was stupid. I should have picked up that chicken. It's a shame that they cut him out, because he's so well animated. State. that. Oh, that's not working, is it? Come on, let me get the chicken. No, it won't let me. It'll probably restore my health for the next level. It's all good. But what is going on with that music? I know they've done it deliberately. I know it's a choice. It's just not good. It's not a good one. And again, this level's... Remember the music from Streets of Rage 1 and 2? It's just... Sorry, I'm only pausing so you can hear a bit of the music. It's just lacking melody, you know? Definitely doesn't feel very Streets of Rage-y. Not to me, anyway. I think it might be one of the main reasons. Oh, that's the guy. That's the guy I think who'd be used on the first level in the Shiva. Yeah, I think they use him on the first level on the European ones. I might be wrong about that. Shiva's cool looking. He's a proper hard ass karate dude. Well, I don't know. That's not karate, is it? What he's doing. Oof. But he's well animated as well. Okay. He's a good one. But yeah, I think Streets of Rage 2, you get to use him. He's like the bodyguard, isn't he, of the final boss. It's like his little mate. But you get to use him, I think, in Streets of Rage 2 if you complete the game a certain way or do something particular with the control pad. Yeah, which is pretty cool. Okay, so Streets of Rage 3, well no, Bare Knuckle 3 for the Sega Mega Drive. And we'll get to compare this a bit later on with Streets of Rage 3. I say a bit later on. It could be years before we get to S in the Mega Drive. It could be a few months. But yeah, awesome game. Awesome series of games. and my favourite genre, I might add. Thanks for watching. See you later.